DJ OTV. DJ OTV. DJ OTV.
One-stop channel for everything news and gist happening all over the world. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on the time this video got to you. And if this is your first time of seeing any of our videos, please don't forget to go a step further, like, share, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So you'll be one of the first persons to know whenever we drop a new video. Now let's take you straight up to the main news. Sunday, Igbo and other Yoruba leaders drags the federal government to the International Criminal Court. Plus, Ikpeazu introduces Abia's state social identity number. Sunday, Igbo, in conjunction with Professor Banji Akintoye, who is the leader of the Ilana Omo Odua Foundation, and 49 other persons have filed a case with a 27-page petition at the International Criminal Court, dragging the Buhari's administration to the International Criminal Court for genocide against the Yoruba people. Barrister Aderemi Leku Omojola, an international lawyer, is the one who submitted a petition at the International Criminal Court on behalf of the Yoruba leaders. Notable among the 49 other persons who signed the petition against the federal government in conjunction with Akintoye and Sunday Igbowo includes Sheikh Rahim, who is the Imam of Yoruba in Ilorin, Kwara State, Chief Semi Sade Kuku, Babatunde Omololu, who is the leader of Yoruba Strategy Alliance, and the General Secretary of the Ilani Omo Odua, Architect George Akinola, and 44 other persons. The petition, which was sent to the International Criminal Court, has called out President Muhammadu Buhari, Malami, Buratai, and other leaders of the Nigerian government for genocidal offenses which were committed against the Yoruba nation and the petitioners group, causing serious bodily and mental harm to members of the group. They also said that the Buhari-led administration deliberately inflicted on the group conditions of life calculated to bring about destruction in part or in whole physically. The International Criminal Court has acknowledged that they have received the petition. According to Maxwell Adeleye, the head of communications to Chief Akintoye, who is the leader of the Ilani Omo Odua's group, he said that Mr. Mark P. Dillon, who is the head of information and evidence unit of the Office of the Prosecutor at the ICC, he said that he has responded to the group and written that they have received the petition, and as soon as a decision is reached to formally commence investigation into this petition, that they will inform them in writing and provide, of course, reasons for the decision. He said the communication has duly entered into the communications register of the office. We will give consideration to this communication as appropriate in accordance with the provision of the Rome Statute of the International Criminal Court. Those who were dragged to the International Criminal Court include President Muhammadu Buhari, Abubakar Malami, who is the Minister of Justice and also doubles as the Attorney General of the Federation, Tukur Buratai, who is a former Chief of Army Staff, Idris Ibrahim and Mohammed Adamu, who are former Inspector Generals of Police. Others include the Comptroller General of Custom, Ahmed Ali, Inspector General of Police presently, Akali Baba, the present Chief of Army Staff, Farouk Yahaya, former Chief of Air Staff, Sadiq Abubakar, former Commandant of the NSCDC, Abubakar Ahmed Adu, Comptroller General of the Nigerian Immigration Service, Mohammed Babandede, and the current Commandant General of the NSCDC, Abdullahi Gana Muhammadu. Following the reply from the International Criminal Court, the Ilani Omo Odua group have expressed optimism that after the case is being investigated and tried at the International Criminal Court, that the Yoruba nation will finally emerge from Nigeria. Meanwhile, in another recent development, on the 14th of July 2021, Governor Okezie Ikpeazu, who is the governor of Abia State, launched the Abia State Social Identity Number, despite the fact that the National Identity Number is the only recognized identification number for every single Nigerian. Setting the pace for other Abians to follow, Governor Okezie became the first person to enroll in the ASIN scheme at the Governor's Lodge in Aba, and has stressed that the importance of data in governance and administration cannot be overemphasized. Governor Ikpeazu said that the Abia State Social Identity Number will help the Abia State Governor in addressing and planning concerning unemployment issues in the state, demographic distribution of infrastructure and resources, amongst many other things that the government intends to do. He said the identity number will serve as a pass that will guide between relationships between the governors and the citizens of Abia State. He also said, as part of the effort of the government to ensure that everyone in Abia State enrolls in the ASIN, he said the Abia State Social Identification Number will become a requirement in school enrollment and also in registration of businesses by citizens of Abia State. And anyone that has anything to do with the government of Abia State must present their Abia State Social Identity Number. He said that it is a civil responsibility of all Abia State citizens to ensure that they register in the Abia State Social Identification Number scheme, noting that enrollment in the scheme has been made user-friendly and registration is free of charge from the comfort of everyone's home. Adding that the Abia State Social Identification Number, when it becomes fully operational, will be used in the payment of salaries of civil servants, and those who has not registered with the Abia State Social Identification Number scheme would not be able to get their salaries. He also said that with the ASIN, there will be digitalization of the activities of all ministries, departments, and agencies in Abia State. Dr. Nenna Chikezie has said that the ASIN is an identification management platform that will be used to capture the biometric of users, especially in Abia State, stating that 2 million Abia State citizens have been targeted for capturing and registration in the next 12 months, as the ASIN will be the identification for anyone who desires to have services from the Abia State government. She also said that Abia State people in diaspora could enroll in the scheme using their Android phone, which is internet enabled, explaining further that the scheme is long overdue as it was required for planning purposes, including the capturing of the state's developmental strides. She said that the registration will be made public very soon, and has thanked Governor Okezie Ikpeazu for initiating the scheme. But of course, this has not gone down well with everyone, because it's like duplication of resources. Already the National Identification Number is there, and everyone has been asked to register and link with their SIM card for easy identification. But others are saying that the Abia State Social Identification Number is not something that is new, owing to the fact that in other states like in Delta State, where they already have this identification number but for civil servants alone, that Abia State should, you know, copy Delta State and make the Abia State Social Identification Number for just civil servants who are on the payroll of the state government. The initiation of the Abia State Social Identity Number is coming in just as the Minister of Communication and Digital Economy, Dr. Isa Ali Pantami, signed Nigeria up with other Islamic nations in an organization called the Digital Cooperation Organization. So guys, what are your thoughts concerning the issues we have just raised? Drop your comment in the comment section below.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for staying with us till the end of this video. But before we go, we just want to let you know that we're also on Facebook and on Instagram at DJMTV. Also, check out our website at www.djmtv.news. There we drop news 24/7 non-stop. Do not forget that you could also place your advert with us here on DJMTV News, and be rest assured that your business will get to the desired market. Well, so we'll come your way again with another edition of DJMTV Daily News Update. I remain your host, Lawal Favour. Yeah! Oh, 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 oh
DJ LTV. DJ LTV. DJ LTV.